So, welcome to this panel discussion where we are looking closer at an innovative telco partnership looking to disrupt the industry. My name is Mea Thompson, and aside from being a digital telco fanatic and an eSIM geek, I'm also the CCO and founder of unconnected.org, an organization where we're looking to connect 1 billion people to the internet. So let's start introducing this impressive panel. So with me, I've got Robin Major from Moflix. And to make sure I'm not hogging the mic, maybe you can do a quick intro of yourself.
For sure. Thanks, Mea. So I'm Robin Major. I'm the Chief Revenue Officer of Moflix. We're an AWS native software vendor, which is bringing disruptive digital propositions to the telco market.
Fantastic. Then we got Sudhanshu Sena from Totogi. The mic is yours. Who are you and why are you on this panel?
Thank you so much, Mea, and thanks for putting me in this panel. My name is Sudhanshu Sena. I'm the Senior Vice President at Telco DR, and I'm also one of the founding executive members of Totogi. At Totogi, we are trying to reimagine BSS from ground up by writing it completely natively on AWS and a fully planetary scale platform, which is available for anybody to try on AWS Marketplace with the click of a button.
Well, welcome to the panel. Glad to have you here. And last but definitely not least is Visu Sontam from AWS. First of all, thank you for having us in the studio. And you don't need to introduce AWS too much, but introduce yourself, please.
Sure. Thank you, Mea. I'm Visu Sontam. I'm SA leader in go-to-market team driving OSS BSS opportunity in Telco ABU.
Welcome to the panel. And let's take a little step back. So as I'm working to connect the 40% of the world's population currently not connected, it's very clear that the other half is taking connectivity for granted. Consumer expectations have changed dramatically and our lives are moving more and more online. And we've been talking at conferences like this one for ages about disrupting telco with lean digital operating models and cloud native technology. And we've done that for some time, but it seems like the industry is moving slow. Other industries, however, though, seem to be getting it right. And we're seeing new, innovative, bold players coming in, a new breed of operators, and some of them outside of the telco industry. And they're really starting to disrupt this industry, but they are very slow to launch. So the question for today is, how can we support new innovative operator to enter the market quicker? And how will the partnership between AWS, Totogi and Moflix enable just that? So let me kick off with asking you, Robin, a question. Before we get into the actual solution of what you guys are launching, why do you see the need for this telco partnership, and how is the industry changing?
That's a great question. I think, as you said, to most people, it's pretty obvious that consumer expectations have changed dramatically since the introduction of smartphones. You know, there's a whole range of exciting digital services offerings out there in things like entertainment, finance, social media, transportation, I think you name it, there's something out there where they make it just easy for people to onboard themselves and manage their entire service relationship through a simple, intuitive digital app. We even see examples of that happening in the telco industry with people like WhatsApp coming in and really sort of boldly changing the game. Mm-hmm. But I think kind of true to form, the telco players really have been slow to come to the party. And when they have arrived, they've arrived carrying a load of baggage from the way that they've just always done things. Really putting it bluntly, I think they've wasted the last decade rather than sort of trying to get up to speed with what the rest of the world is doing, really looking inwardly at a whole wave of transformation programs focused on incremental improvements to IT processes and legacy IT systems, rather than reimagining themselves through the lens of what's really needed from these new modern consumers.
I love it when someone says to put it bluntly. I was laughing because that means some hard truth is coming out. But like I mentioned before, and you kind of touched on about the new disruptors coming in, how do you see them impacting the way that telco is evolving?
Yeah, so these new players have come to the same party, but they've arrived with a bold new vision for how to win the hearts and minds of these consumers. And innovative ways of monetizing those relationships. So, you know, those are the guys who are really going to win in this new digital economy. They understand that a new way of thinking about the telco operating model is required, and a new way of thinking about consumer engagement, and they've come with a radical new approach for implementing, you know, lean operating processes, for disruptive ways of monetizing relationships. That really is putting them in pole position when it comes to this new way of doing business. We'll be seeing them driving whole new ways of doing things in a much more radical way that's going to change the nature of the industry. I think we're also seeing them realize that they can't get the kind of results they're looking for by partnering with the same old telco vendors that the industry's become reliant on for so many years, and they're looking to partner with, you know, disruptive thought leaders like the people on this panel. You know, we're all providing solutions based on the AWS stack. We're natively looking for ways of creating value that allow operators to disrupt their markets and find new ways of doing things. You know, that's what the Anto, the AWS Native Telco Partnership, is all about. And now it's a really exciting time to be in telco again.
Ah, that's exciting times indeed. And I saw you were nodding and following the conversation as well. And so, Sudhanshu, just before we started airing this outside in the halls with the masses of people here at MWC, we had a conversation, and you mentioned it's really crucial for these new innovative operators to be able to launch quicker and more streamlined. Do you mind just elaborating a little bit on that?
No, absolutely. Let me start with an anecdote and then sort of build that story from there on. A few years ago, I met with the founder of an MVNO who wanted to launch an MVNO combining digital content for Indian diaspora in the European market. And he wanted to combine the content with connectivity and deliver to the end customers. Unfortunately, it took him 9 months to figure out a BSS stack which will help him to launch an MVP into the market. Because of which, the OTT content partners were not so patient. They decided to launch their app directly into the market, completely killing the business model for this MVNO. Subsequently, the investors pulled out the backing, and the MVNO was dead within the next 6 months. Unfortunately, this story is not just true for this MVNO or this market. It's globally applicable. In fact, the data shows that only up to 20% of the MVNOs actually succeed after their launch. And it comes down to three or four complex problems which we are dealing as an industry. We have a complicated process of sourcing. We have complicated systems. The integration takes too long. And then your runway is too small to prove your viability in the market. Imagine if we can flip it around and give every invention out there an opportunity to jumpstart their brand and take that MVP to the market. The amount of innovation which will come out will be unprecedented. And this is exactly what this industry needs. And that's what we are trying to do with this coalition.
I was going to start with saying that's a great story, but it wasn't a great story because it didn't end up very good for the company you talked about. But it does really show the need for us to be able to find a better way on onboarding new MVNOs. So Visu from AWS, tell us a bit more why Totogi and Moflix. Why would you say that this is such a groundbreaking partnership?
Sure. So AWS has a vast number of partners allowing customers to choose based on their needs. And Totogi and Moflix are strategic partners in BSS space. Moflix offering digital all-inclusive, all-in telco app, and also Totogi offering real-time charging and ability for operators to do network intelligence. It's a perfect combination. So together for this combination, operators can innovate faster and also leverage AWS capabilities to be ahead of the curve.
So I get it sounds like a great partnership. You got all the pieces there for the perfect recipe or for the perfect dish. But you mentioned before about the Anto concept. Tell us a bit more about the Anto.
Sure. So together, we came up with it together, AWS, Totogi, and Moflix came up with a concept called Anto. Anto is AWS Native Telco Operator, where operators, as Sudhanshu mentioned, operators can use the solution together as an infrastructure, as a code, and able to spin up instances, spin up the whole solution within minutes, and able to come up with the solution so that they can innovate faster, they can think about more about their business rather than thinking about infrastructure and how they are, how the underlying aspect, but they think about their businesses.
Thank you, thank you. And Robin, Visu was talking about Anto. You mentioned Anto before. What does Anto mean to you?
Look, Mia, I think Anto is a game changer. It's as simple as that. The AWS Native Telco Operator is the first end-to-end telco in a box solution that leverages the native capabilities of AWS to provide a full telco stack that an MVNO or an MNO who wants to be disruptive can launch by pressing one single button in the AWS marketplace. And you know, it brings together some of the most disruptive ISVs in the telco space today, starting with Totogi and Moflix. We're really sort of changing the way that people think about how quickly you can instantiate one of these new greenfield digital brands. I think the other thing that's really cool for me about Anto is, you know, whilst everyone on this panel here is part of the sort of the core of the coalition, it's an ecosystem play. So over time, we'll be looking to expand the footprint of the capability as we identify more AWS native ISVs who think that they can contribute to the solution and add value to the footprint. So if there are any, you know, budding AWS native ISVs out there who think that they can contribute to this, then, you know, let's get them, get in touch and see if we can talk about bringing them into the Anto coalition.
Awesome. And one question though, because you mentioned before that it took 9 months for this part, for the telco to find a BSS, was it right? Yeah. And then they went bust. And you're saying now that you've got this new solution that can launch a telco a lot quicker. Like how much quicker are we talking?
Yeah, Visu said in minutes. It is in minutes, but it's certainly under an hour. When you know, a traditional IT telco stack deployment is easily going to take you a year. So it's a huge improvement in terms of the expectations.
So you can launch an operator in an hour.
That's what we're saying.
Yeah. Okay. So I guess, Sudhanshu, looking at Anto, except for being able to launch in an hour, what are the other opportunities that you see with this concept from Totogi?
I think the opportunity and the potential is enormous, right? Totogi and Moflix have the same opportunity to do to BSS what Salesforce and Tableau did to CRM and revenue recognition, which is to completely change the way people think about these platforms or these business goals of revenue recognition.
Can I also, just to add in that answer, can you ask, why did you choose AWS? Can you add that in as well?
For sure. I mean, I think before I go into that, I think for me, like I said, the opportunity to do sales, you know, opportunity for Totogi and Moflix is to do to BSS what Salesforce and Tableau did for the CRM, then the revenue recognition, which is to come up with a globally available planetary scale platform, which delivers on your business goals, but it's pay by use. And anybody can get and started and up and running and start doing their business with these platforms. I think with the collaboration with Moflix, we have taken that step a journey further where you can not only monetize your network, but you can take these plans to the consumer with a first-class experience, which today's generations expect. Now, as far as why we decide to go with AWS, was obviously to sit in this panel and talk a little about it. But that was not the reason. We started 2 years ago doing this, and there were three key reasons why we chose AWS. Number one, their speed of expansion. Today, they have 31 regions, 90 local zones, and they're continuing to expand. Every region they deploy, it's a vehicle for us to attack that market. So me and Robin can go and tell that market that now our platform is available for you to try. Number two, their speed of innovation. They ship product and innovation faster than any other hyperscaler. And every innovation they ship is a vehicle for us to show our value add on top of it. Last but not the least is the AWS Marketplace, which is a great procurement engine which simplifies the buying process of these technology in a click of a button. I think with that, with my original story, I talked about all the complexities, and I think AWS is helping us to solve all three of them in one shot. So that's why we decided to go with AWS.
And it's a perfect bridge. Visu, you must love that answer, obviously. But coming from AWS, what is the key business impact that you aim to kind of focus at or deliver on?
Definitely, I'm loving this whole panel discussion.
I knew you were going to say that.
The strategic partnership of AWS, Moflix, and Totogi, and bringing the SaaS solution out of AWS Marketplace, where customers can really enable, take the SaaS and don't have to worry about going for taking from AWS Marketplace. That's a key thing I want to add, AWS Marketplace, so that customers can experiment faster, fail cheap. At the same time, okay, they can have the, they can be ahead of the curve because of the SaaS environments. And what I'm liking this is entirely cloud native way they have built using managed Kubernetes, purpose built databases, as well as logging and monitoring and governance with AWS, and serverless capabilities of AWS, step functions and DynamoDB. So that's what is completely native AWS way, which is really helping, going to help the customers to be ahead of the curve, and also they can see how they can monetize the 5G as well as MVNO, enabling MVNOs and operators.
Fantastic, thank you. And as we're running closer to the end of this discussion, I want to put you all on the spot though, to give you a bit of a challenge. So I want you all to answer one question, and I want you to target it to a different type of personality or a person, right? So the question I want you to answer is, what value do you bring to the telco industry, with you being like the partnership, I mean? So answer less than 10 seconds. I'm looking, Robin, you're closest to me. So
thanks.
I'm going to start with you. So answer the question, what value do you bring to the telco industry? But you need to answer it like you are talking to a chief commercial officer. And the clock starts now.
That's a tough shout. I'll give it my best shot. So if I'm a chief commercial officer, then Anto allows me to respond to market pressures really quickly and launch a greenfield digital operator in record time. It reduces the time to revenue for my new business and allows me to be really creative in terms of the way that I continue to evolve it. My teams are free to have good ideas and launch them to the market very quickly, to monetize the service in really innovative ways, and to do things that are just being focused on boosting my NPS, my engagement, and my top and bottom line.
Well done. You didn't keep to 10 seconds, though.
I counted to
12 in my head, but that's all right. So, Sudhanshu, I guess you get 8 seconds then.
Just kind of even it out.
Sorry.
Sorry,
you answered the same question. What value do you bring? And you are chatting with the chief information officer. How would you pitch it?
So number one is responding to the business quickly. I think that's the primary goal. Responding to the business quickly, ability to experiment faster, ability to retain smarter talents and attract better talents towards their workforce. And in the end, doing all of this without spending millions of dollars. That's my message for the CIO.
Okay, that was 9 seconds. So we're down 1 second for the last one. No, I'm just joking. You get 10 seconds like
he
the other ones.
He definitely pulled it back.
Yeah, I know. So you get the same question. You're speaking with the chief financial officer. How would you phrase it to get them on board?
Sure. Ability to save billions of dollars by using...
Well, that's a good start. Yeah.
By using infrastructure as code and with the best solution between Totogi and Moflix, and rather than just depending on going with the whole procurement and leveraging the existing infrastructure.
Well done, that was 10 seconds sharp. So, well, to kind of round this up, I want to thank you all for your time on this panel and your presence. It's been great to learn more about the Anto concept, and I'm really looking forward to see what the future brings for you guys and for the telco industry. If someone that sees this video wants to understand more about this partnership and get some more information, there will be a link underneath this video that you can click through to see more details and be able to click through to you guys. So thank you so much for joining me on this panel today. And
fantastic. Thank you, Mea.
Thank you, Mea.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.